Hello everyone, assalamualaikum. Well, let's take a look. So this is my sign in form, and over here the whole form is wrapped around a column. Okay, now the problem is once I click on this, the keyboard shows up and I get an error, okay, regardless where I tap. Okay, now one way to fix it very quickly is to use a property inside scaffold which is called resize to avoid bottom inset to false. I think the default property is true, that's why you get the error. Now let's save it and click on this and the error is gone. All right, yeah. Now the same could be applied for if you have other forms like this here. This is a signup form. Okay, now I still get this error. Now let's go ahead and find the signup form. I still have here a column. Okay, now here I can do resize to avoid bottom inset to false, and I will save it and the error is gone. Okay, all right. Okay, now this is one problem though, even though it solves the problem, but it creates a new problem. I would say you can't really scroll. Okay, so we want to scroll actually, otherwise sometimes the space is not enough, you want to type in for a long time. Okay, so in that case this is not a very good solution. So what I would do, I would remove this. So we have to make this column scrollable, that's all we want, because we just have one column here. So we want to make it scrollable, or any column you want to make it scrollable, then the solution would work. Because what we want, as we tap on this, we want it to go up a little bit and we want it to happen automatically. Okay, so we can do it easily actually. So all we need to do, we need to wrap this column around a single child scroll view. Okay, so that's what we would do. So we would do option enter on Mac and it would ask me to wrap it around a widget, and that's what I would do here. And here I would do scroll single child scroll view, actually single child scroll view. And here we need to set up another property which is physics, and it is a property called bouncing scroll physics, this one. Okay, all right, now let's save it. Okay, now let's come over here. You see the error doesn't pop up and it has this cool thing, it goes up automatically. Okay, and it might I mean, if you have more options, then you can scroll it up and down like this. So simply just put your column or the section which one you want to make scrollable, that part you wrap around this single child scroll view, and then you just use the property which is called physics property, bouncing scroll physics. Okay, now we'll use the same property for our sign up page and we'll see the error is gone. But anyway, now let's move on to sign up page first over here. Now in default property we do get this error, right? So what we'll do, we'll just wrap it around single child scroll view. So single child scroll view, and we set up the physics property bouncing scroll physics. So now the error is gone and you can also scroll it up and down. Okay, once you are done, it goes back to its original position immediately. Okay, all right, so that's how it works. Thank you so much.